Hello friends, welcome to the Plant Science Forum. In this series of talk about the systematic studies and economic importance of some angiospermic plant families, today's topic of discussion is family Solanaceae from Gamopetalae. This is the systematic position for family Solanaceae as per the Bentham-Hooker and Engler-Prandtl system of classification. Unlike Engler-Prandtl system of classification, Bentham and Hooker had proposed series Bicarpellidae as an intermediate taxon between subclass and order. Also, to understand the difference between both the system, just look at the different suffix used after the name of the taxon. Again, another difference is that both the system of classification had proposed different names for the subclass and order. There are many more differences in these two systems of classification, but here I have discussed only with respect to this slide for systematic position. The family Solanaceae is distributed in tropical and subtropical regions of the world, and only few members are present in the temperate region. In this image, you can locate which part of the world belongs to tropical region, subtropical region and temperate region. Most of the members of Solanaceae are cultivated all around the world for edible purposes. Few names among these are tomato, potato, brinjals, chili. These are very familiar names which belongs to the family Solanaceae. About 102 genera and 2800 species are reported from family Solanaceae around the world. These are some of the well-known common plants belonging to the family Solanaceae. Just correlate the name and shown images as per their number. First is Solanum tuberosum, that is potato. Second is Nicotiana tabacum, that is tobacco plant. Third is Lycopersicon esculentum, that is tomato. Fourth is Solanum melongena, that is eggplant or say brinjal. Fifth is Capsicum annuum, that is chili. Sixth is Datura stramonium, which is a very common weed. Seventh is Solanum nigrum, which is a potential medicinal plant. And eighth is Petunia, a well-known ornamental plant. Now discuss the vegetative characters for family Solanaceae. The habit shown by Solanaceae members is mostly herb, sometimes shrub or tree, and rarely vines and lianas. As being member of dicot, the root shows taproot system, and in some tuberous roots is also present. Stem is aerial, erect, herbaceous, woody, and solid. Solid means not hollow or without large air cavities. Sometimes stem is also modified into tubers. In Solanaceae, leaves are ex-stipulate, simple. Simple means directly borne on stem, rarely pinnately compound. Phyllotaxy is alternate. Margin of the leaves is entire but sometimes shows dissected, and the venation is reticulate unicostate. Now let's revise the vegetative characters with respect to the character images. Please note that some of the images shown here in this video presentation are just representative of the characters concerned and not necessarily belongs to the family Solanaceae. Here Solanum melongena shows herb habit, Solanum brownii shows shrub habit, and Brugmansia candida, it is a small tree, and Mandragora officinarum, you can see here the roots modified into tubers, while Solanum tuberosum shows stem modified into tubers. The family Solanaceae is Extubulate means without small leaf like appendages at the base of the petiole, as you can see here. Leaf type is simple or sometimes pinnately compound. Now let's discuss floral characters of the family Solanaceae. Inflorescence is cymose. Inflorescence is cymose or solitary. Now cymose means older flower is at the apex by terminating the floral axis and younger flowers born below to it. So older is at apex and younger is at base. Such type of inflorescence is called as cymose. Whereas solitary means the floral axis is terminated by a single flower. So it is a solitary. Sometimes it also shows axillary cyme inflorescence. Axillary cyme means one or more flowers in the axil of the fully developed leaf. If there are more than one, the flowers are arranged in paired flowered cyme. Another type of inflorescence is Rhyphidium. It is a fan-shaped cymose inflorescence in which the branches lie in the same plane and are suppressed alternately on each side. Flowers are bracteate and sometimes ebracteate also. Bracteates, it is a small leaf-like structure present at the base of the pedicel, that is floral axis. If it is present, then called as bracteate, and if such small leaf-like structure is absent, then it is called as ebracteate. Flowers are hermaphrodite, means bisexual, having both male and female. They are actinomorphic, means they can be divided into equal halves by any plane passing through the center. This shows actinomorphic flower. Flower is hypogynous, means all other floral whorls or appendages are born from below the ovary. In some flowers also shows presence of corona. Just see in this image of Gyaltomata calyantha. Here, this red color in the flower, this red color is a nectary, and these nectary are present on the green hood-like appendages. That structure is called as corona. Now let's discuss calyx and corolla. In both of them, individual members, that is sepals and petals, are 5 in number and are fused, so called gamosepalous and gamopetalous respectively. Among the various shapes for calyx and corolla, the family Solanaceae shows rotate, tubular or funnel shape. Here Solanum melongena shows rotate shape, while Datura shows funnel shaped and Vestia shows tubular shape. This is rotate shape. The rotate means wheel shaped. In this calyx or corolla, these lobes are fused with flat, circular and spreading limbs at nearly right angle to a very short tube. Important feature of the family Solanaceae is the persistent calyx, as you can see here. Persistent calyx. That means a portion or whole of the sepals remains with the fruit even after the maturity and do not shed off. Everybody might have seen in the brinjal and tomato, there is a green structure which is nothing but the sepals. And after maturity, The ovary becomes fruit and sepal remains as it is. So it is a persistent. Aestivation in calyx is valvate. Means member of the valves remain side by side and do not overlap. Corolla shows both valvate and imbricate aestivation. Imbricate means one member of the valve is completely inside and one member is completely outside, whereas other three, they are alternating to or overlapping to each other. In Solanaceae, anthers are five, but sometimes staminode is also present. Staminode means abnormal or immature stamen or sterile stamen. Stamens are present on the petals, so called epipetalous. Mostly, length of filament is shorter than corolla tube, so remain within the corolla, so called as inserted. The connection between anther lobe and filament, that is connective, it is sometimes enlarged. Gynoecium are two and fused, so called syncarpus. Ovary is present above all other floral valves, so called superior. The carpel undergo twisting and they are placed obliquely because of posterior carpel turned to a right and anterior carpels are turned to the left. The ovary shows bilocular nature and placentation is exile and many ovules in a single locule. Now let's again revise the characters with respect to the images. Now just see here, you can see there are five anthers, and because length of the filament is not greater as compared to the corolla tube, so the anthers are within the corolla, that's why they are inserted. Here you can see anthers or stamens, they are attached to the petals, so they are epipetalous. Here this is the connective region which is showing enlargement in size. Here you can see the gynoecium is present. This is the position of ovary and sepals are born from lower side. Anthers are also born from lower side. So ovary is, gynoecium is superior and the flower is hypogynous. Now here you can see these two hollow structure, which is nothing but two locules, which you can correlate with this tomato image. In the tomato also, you can see this is the central axis. Just a minute. This is the central axis in the longitudinal section, but if you cut it by transverse section, then you can see this is the central axis. So there are two locules and many ovules. And see here, this is the floral diagram for Solanaceae. In this you can see this is the floral axis and the one of the ovary has turned right side and another ovary has just turned left side, and now they are not perpendicular to the floral axis. They are not perpendicular to the floral axis, but just they are tilted and obliquely placed. So this is how the characters of Androecium and Gynoecium are in family Solanaceae. In Solanaceae, major fruit type is berry or capsule. Berry type means simple fleshy fruit that usually has many seeds such as grape and tomato. As a simple fruit, a berry is derived from a single ovary of individual flower. The middle inner layers of the fruit wall often are not distinct from each other. Here tomato is a berry fruit. Another type of fruit is capsule fruit. It is a type of simple dry fruit, although rarely fleshy, dehiscent fruit produced by many species of angiosperm. This is just a minute. This is a capsule. In the family Solanaceae, pollination is entomophilous, butterfly and by moths. You can see in the images how pollinators are involved in pollination in family Solanaceae. The floral formula for family Solanaceae is bracteate or ebracteate, actinomorphic, bisexual, or you can say hermaphrodite. Calyx is 5, but they are fused, so gamosepalous. Corolla is 5, but fused, so gamopetalous. Androecium is 5, free, but present on the corolla, that's why epipetalous. Gynoecium is 2 and fused, so syncarpous. Gynoecium is superior, flower is hypogynous, so here dash is present below the G. So this is the floral formula. Here you can see a floral diagram. The outermost whorl is, outermost green whorl is sepals or say calyx, and the inner is petals. Here for both of them, estivation shown is valvate. Now anthers shown here are epipetalous, and the ovary is obliquely placed with axile placentation and two locules with many ovules. Diagnostic features for the family is habit shows shrub or herb type. Leaves are simple, alternate phyllotaxy. They are X-stipulate. Stamens are epipetalous. Calyx is enlarged. Ovary is obliquely placed. Placenta is swollen and many ovules are present. And the general fruit type is berry or capsule. The family Solanaceae has many economic importance. Among them, some are mentioned here. As in vegetable, you can see a Solanum tuberosum, that is potato. Solanum melongena, that is brinjal or say eggplant. Capsicum annuum, that is chili. Now lowermost image is Solanum xanthocarpum. The roots of this plant is used in cough and asthma, so it is a potential medicinal plant. And the last one in this image is Nicotiana tabacum. Plant image is not shown, but only name is mentioned. Nicotiana tabacum, that is tobacco plant. Now this tobacco has many economic values, but the product of these plants are, they are harmful and addictives. So such as tobacco and cigarettes. I hope you understood the topic. If you like the contents of the topic, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.